So we have seen up to the T wave, normal and abnormal. Now we are going to discuss about the U wave. Okay. So before we go for the U wave abnormality and the normal U wave, we'll understand the physiology of the U wave. Fine. So physiology of the U wave. Now there are two theories to tell how the U waves are generated. One theory says the U wave is due to repolarization of the M cell, that is mid myocardial cell. Okay, so the M cell repolarization will cause the U wave. Other theory says it's due to the delayed repolarization of the Purkinje fiber. Okay, so this is Purkinje fiber delayed repolarization. So these are the two theories to tell how the U waves are generated: mid myocardial M cell repolarization or Purkinje fiber delayed repolarization. Fine, this is the U wave physiology. Now let's see what is normal U wave. Now U wave can be seen normally that follows the T wave. This is P wave, QRS, T and U. Now normal U waves are mostly seen in lead V2 and V3. Now the amplitude of the U wave should be less than 25% of the preceding T wave. Okay. And the normal U wave amplitude never exceeds more than 5 mm. Fine. Now the amplitude of U wave is inversely proportional to the heart rate. So we can understand when there is a bradycardia, it is more likely we will see the U wave. Okay. So this is about the U wave normality. Now this is normal U wave. Let's understand what is the abnormality of the U wave. So abnormality of the U wave can be either a prominent U wave or an inverted U wave. First we understand what is prominent U wave. Fine. So here you can see this is P, this is QRS, then T, and this is your prominent U wave. Okay. So prominent U wave amplitude will be more than 25% of the preceding T wave. That is the first criteria to tell the U is prominent. Fine. So this is the prominent U wave. Now which are the conditions where you see the prominent U wave? Okay. So normally the prominent U wave can be seen with the bradycardia. Fine. So with normally with bradycardia you can see the prominent U wave. Otherwise, other causes of prominent U wave is the hypokalemia. Okay. So hypokalemia is the one situation where prominent U wave is a very good clue. Along with that, hypocalcemia, hypomagnesemia, hypothermia, that also can cause prominent U wave. Some drugs like digoxin and class 1 and class 3 antiarrhythmic also cause the prominent U wave. So this was about the prominent U wave. Now we understood about the inverted U wave. Okay, now you can see in this complex P wave, QRS, T, and then you have the inverted U wave. Okay, so this is the inverted U wave. Now inverted U wave is a very good clue to the coronary artery disease. Fine. So inverted U wave is never a normal phenomenon. If a patient ECG has inverted U wave, it suggests patient can be having coronary artery disease. So we have understood about the T wave and U wave. Now we'll discuss some miscellaneous waves which are not common exam viva in undergraduate, but they are important to remember when it comes to practice. Okay. So we start first with the Osborne wave. Okay. Now Osborne wave is a wave which is seen at the as a J point elevation. Now what is J point elevation? Where the QRS ends and ST segment starts, it is called J point. Now this J point gets elevated like this, which is shown in this image. It's called Osborne wave. Okay, so J point elevation is a Osborne wave. In which condition this Osborne wave is seen? It is seen in hypothermia. Okay, so this is the classical example of the Osborne wave which is seen in the hypothermia. One more condition called hypercalcemia. Hypercalcemia, Osborne wave is seen. Okay. Now, how to differentiate whether this Osborne wave is due to hypothermia or due to hypercalcemia? It's very simple when it comes to the clinical approach. Just check the temperature of the patient. In hypothermia, the temperature will be low. In hypercalcemia, you don't expect a normal temperature only. Sometimes it can cause increased temperature even. Okay, and check with the serum calcium, it will be high in the hypercalcemia. Now, how to differentiate on ECG whether the Osborne wave is due to hypercalcemia and or hypothermia? Now if you see the QT interval, which we are going to discuss in the next video, the QT interval is prolonged in the case of hypothermia, while QT interval is short in case of the hypercalcemia. Okay, so this is the Osborne wave and the causes are hypothermia and hypercalcemia. Now we will understand about something called epsilon wave. Okay, now epsilon wave is a positive deflection just after the QRS complex. Now this epsilon wave is seen in case of the ARVD. Okay, that's the A for arrhythmogenic, RV for right ventricular, and D for dysplasia. Okay, so ARVD stands for arrhythmogenic right ventricular dysplasia. It is one of the cause for the sudden death, sudden cardiac death. Okay, so ARVD, it's one of the cause of the sudden death. Fine. So this is the epsilon wave, which is seen in the condition called ARVD. So this was about the epsilon wave. Now we'll discuss a little common condition called delta wave. Fine. Now delta wave is seen in the condition called WPW syndrome. WPW syndrome. So Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome. Okay, Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome, you will find the delta wave. Okay, so what is delta wave? Delta wave is the initial slurring of the QRS complex. Here you can see the QRS complex is slurred at the initial deflection. Okay, so this is called delta wave. Now we try to understand how this delta wave is generated. Fine. So to understand the delta wave, we should know that heart has atria and the ventricle, and both are separated with the AV ring, which is isoelectrical. Normally the conduction starts with the SA node, then goes to the AV node, then after the AV node it goes to the His bundle. After His bundle, left bundle branch block, left bundle branch and right bundle branch. After left branch and right branch, you have Purkinje fibers and the depolarized starts. This is the normal direction: SA node, AV node, bundle of His, left bundle, right bundle, then you have Purkinje fibers. Okay, in the WPW syndrome, you will have one additional accessory pathway which connects atria to the ventricle directly. Okay, now normally we know the PR interval is due to the delay in the AV node. Okay, now when there is an accessory pathway from atria, the current goes directly to the ventricle without the PR interval there, or without the AV node connection there. So the PR interval shortens. Okay, that's the first criteria. You can see here the PR interval is shortened, correct? After P, immediately there comes the QRS complex. So the first thing, PR interval shortens. Okay, now when you can see here, from here the current is coming directly to the ventricle muscle. Okay, so it comes to the muscle. Now the activation will be from muscle to muscle, that is little slower than the Purkinje fibers. So your initial QRS deflection becomes blurred. That is the delta wave. Okay, so that is the delta wave. Now the second phenomenon we understood, muscle to muscle conduction and delta wave. The next phenomenon to tell, when these things are happening, along with that current will be going from this direction also. So SA node to AV node and AV node to the bundle and then the Purkinje fibers. That will catch up with the current which is from the accessory pathway. So once it catches up, it becomes a smooth QRS complex, that is here. Okay, so this is the generation of delta wave which is seen in the condition called Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome. So here we have understood about the all the waves like T wave, U wave, epsilon wave, Osborne wave and delta wave. Next, in the PowerPoint, we'll try to understand with the real-time ECG example how it helps in the clinics. If you are learning something from our videos, subscribe to our channel and like our videos. You can suggest something in the comment. We'll try to improve further. Thank you.